I'm Avinash Lambert, your economics guru, and welcome to the online tutorial sessions for economics. Today we are going to continue our third chapter, which is national income. And students, today we are going to do some numerical questions for calculating the national income and other important aggregates. Now let's start with the first numerical. So we have to find out gross value added. Basically, we have to calculate GVAMP. Or we can say that just we have to calculate the value added. Is that clear? Now, these are the things and we have to calculate the value added. So what's the formula of value added? Value added is equal to value of output minus intermediate consumption. So students, what is the value of output here? Value of output, we have to calculate the value of output. And what's the value of output? Formula of a value of output, we have to calculate it. Now value of output, let's calculate it. For value of output, we need sales. Is there any sales given? Sales is given, but domestic sales is given. Domestic sales is 500 rupees and exports are 1000. So the collective sale, it will be collective sales. For sales, we have to add both of these. We have to calculate exports plus domestic sales. Then we can have the value of sales. Now next, change in stock. What is change in stock? Closing stock minus opening stock. So closing stock minus opening stock. Now next thing, self-consumption. What is self-consumption? Self-consumption is rupees 100. Now we can have the value. Export 1000, domestic sales 500. It will be rupees 1500 plus closing stock 200, opening stock 180. It will be rupees 20. Now Self-consumption is rupees 100. Now, we can have the value of output. Value of output is rupees 1620. Now, let's calculate the value of intermediate consumption. Intermediate consumption means purchase of raw material, and the purchases are given in two things, domestic purchases and intermediate purchases. What should be included? Or both should be included? We should include only the intermediate purchases. Intermediate purchases, not the domestic. Domestic purchases comes under the intermediate purchases. Domestic purchase is a part of intermediate purchase. Intermediate purchase is a bigger thing. So the value of intermediate purchases is the value of intermediate consumption. So intermediate consumption is equal to rupees 90. Now we can calculate the value of value added. Now so value added is equal to value of output, which is rupees 1620 minus intermediate consumption. What is the value of intermediate consumption? This is the value of intermediate consumption, rupees 90. We can have the value of value added, or we can say GVAMP will be rupees 1530. This will be the value of GVAMP. Is that clear, students? लेट्स कम टू द सेकंड न्यूमेरिकल. यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट GVMP एंड NVAFC विद दीस वैल्यूज. नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, वी विल टेक केयर ऑफ फर्स्ट थिंग विच इज GVAMP. GVAMP सिंपली मीन्स वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू एडेड. ग्रॉस वैल्यू एडेड एट मार्केट प्राइस और वैल्यू एडेड बोथ आर सेम थिंग. नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड. We know the formula of value added is equal to value of output and intermediate consumption. Now first we have to calculate the value of output. So to calculate the value of output, we need sales. Is there sales given? Yes. Sales given rupees 1500. Why we have not included domestic sales and exports? Because sales include all these components. Sales already has rupees 1000 in domestic sales and export rupees 200. Sales is a bigger thing and domestic sales and exports are the parts of sales. Fine. So we will take only sales. Sales. It includes sales from abroad and sales in our country only. So we have taken only sales. Now, next is change in stock. What is change in stock? Closing stock minus opening stock. So closing stock is rupees 50 and opening stock is rupees 10. So closing stock minus opening stock. There we go. And is there any self consumption? No. Self consumption is zero. So we will write it as zero. So we can have the value of value output. Value of output is rupees 1500 plus 40. Thus, it is rupees 1540. Now, we have to calculate the value of intermediate consumption. What are intermediate consumption? Purchase of raw material. So, intermediate consumption means purchase of raw material. Now, where are the purchases? Purchases from firm A. And imports are also given. These two things are given. It means purchase from firm A means purchases from the domestic country. And imports mean purchases from the outside the country. Here no point indicates the total purchase. So we will include the components of purchase of raw material. So we will add both of these things. Purchase from domestic territory, this is rupees 200. Plus imports rupees 90. It will be 290. Now we can calculate the value of GVAMP or value added. Value added means value of output minus intermediate consumption. So value added is equal to value of output, which is rupees 1540 minus intermediate consumption, which is 290. We can have the value added, which will be rupees 1540. The second part, which is NVAFC, we have to calculate NVAFC. We need to calculate NVAFC. Now, we have one similar aggregate like GVMP. We have calculated the value of value added, which is 1250 rupees. It is also known as GVAMP, as I told in the earlier part. Now, with the help of GVMP, can we calculate NVAFC? With the help of GVMP, can we calculate NVAFC? We have to convert this G into N and we have to convert this market price into factor cost. Now, from gross to net value, if we want to convert the gross value into net value, what we do? We deduct the depreciation. And what we do while converted the market price into factor cost? We deduct the net indirect taxes. Is that clear? Now, value of GVAMP is 1250. Value of depreciation is rupees 100. and value of indirect taxes is 20. So we can have the value of NVAFC, which will be 1130 rupees. So this is your second part. Is that clear, students? Okay, let's move to the next question. Next question, the third one. Here, intermediate consumption and value of output are given, but they are given sector wise. The intermediate consumption of primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector, and value of output of primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector. Now we will calculate the GDP MP. Now what is GDP MP? GDP MP is the sum of all the GVA MP. And how do we calculate GVMP? We calculate by calculating the value added of all the sectors. So we have to calculate the value added of all the three sectors. Now let's start. Let's start the value added of primary sector. First, we have to calculate the primary sector. Fine. Value added is equal to value of output minus intermediate consumption. Value of output minus intermediate consumption, which is 1125 minus 400. Now, calculate it yourself. Now, secondary sector. Secondary sector, the same thing we will do. Value added is equal to value of output minus intermediate consumption. What the value of output? That is 1200 minus 325. Now, same thing goes with the tertiary sector. Tertiary sector, value added is equal to value of output minus intermediate consumption. Value of output is given, which is 1500 minus tertiary sector, which is 500. So let's calculate it and then move it further. Students, don't forget to write the unit of crore, as in the question rupees and crore both are mentioned. So do not forget. Now we have calculated the value of each sector. Now to have the value of GDP, we need to add all the value added. So GVA, sigma GVA MP is equal to all the value added, that is rupees 725 crore plus rupees 875 crores plus rupees 1000 crores. You have to calculate the GVA MP. Added, it will be rupees 2600 crore. And sigma GVA MP is equal to rupees 2600 crores, which is the GDP also. So the GDP MP will be this. So this is your answer. Is that clear, students? The last question for this video, the fourth one, which is you have to calculate the value of NVAFC with the help of these things. Now we have to calculate NVAFC. How to calculate NVFC? We can calculate the value of GVAMP with these values. Is that clear? How? Because we know the value of output and we know the value of intermediate consumption. Now, before calculating this, we will calculate the value of GVAMP, which is value added. Now we have to calculate the value of added value. Now let's start. First we have to calculate the value of output. Value of output is equal to what's the formula? Sales plus change in stock plus self-consumption. So what is sales here? Sales to firm means domestic sales. They are talking about domestic sales. So domestic sales plus export, both the things will be included. Sales to firm and domestic sales is also given. Not sales to firm, domestic sales and exports. Domestic sales includes all the sales done by the firm. So we will include domestic sales, which the sale which has been done inside the country, and export which has been sold outside the country. So we will have the value of domestic sales plus exports, which is rupees 100, plus change in stock. How to calculate the value of change in stock? Closing stock minus opening stock. So what is the closing stock? 90 minus opening stock, which is 20. Now, is there any self-consumption? Yes, self-consumption is there, which is 40. Now we can calculate the value of output, which is it will be 40. So this is the value of output. Is that clear? Now the value of output. Let's calculate the value of intermediate consumption. Intermediate consumption. Now, how to calculate the value of intermediate consumption? By purchase of raw material. Now, there are domestic purchases and imports. We have to add them and we can get the total purchase of raw material. We have to add them because there is not a single entity which shows the total purchase of raw material. So we have to add these two to have purchase of raw material. So domestic purchases are rupees 100 crore plus imports is rupees 10 crore. Now we have got the value of intermediate consumption and we have got the value of output. So we can have the value added. Now value added will be value of output 1210 minus 110, which will be 0011 crores. So the value added is 1100 crore. Now what we have to do, we have gross value added at market price. So this value added can be written as GVAMP, rupees 1100 crores. Is that clear? Now with the help of this, we can calculate our question, which is NVAFC. We have to calculate NVAFC with the help of GVAMP. Now to convert gross value into net value and to convert market price into factor cost. To convert gross value into net value, what we do? We deduct the depreciation, and to convert the market price into factor cost, we deduct the net indirect taxes. Now the value of GVAMP is 1100, depreciation is 50 crores and NIT is 40 crores. Now can we calculate the value of NVFC? NVAFC is equal to 1100 minus 90. The value NVAFC will be 1010 crores. So is that clear? So that were four numericals, and I hope these numericals have more cleared your mind regarding gross value added at market price and NVAFC. Basically value added method has been completed. In the next turn, I'll bring some more numericals and we'll start with the new method. So that's all for today and Stay home, stay safe.